What's good, YouTube? It's your boy MarRPG. I hope you're having an amazing morning, afternoon, or evening, wherever you are in the world. Let's get back into Tales of Berseria. Let's get into a fight.
You're fighting the Reaper.
Smash them.
Too slow.
Crash through.
Let's go. Let's go.
Twin Wing.
Twin
Wing Cycle. Take that. Devour. Twin Wing. Gosh, leave it to me. Right here! Tap, tap!
Yep. How's this?
This works!
Forget the pain and move!
Spell absorber!
Quickness!
Right here! Ha! Ha! Collider strike the hermit!
Are there more?
Trap trap!
I'll get it!
Fake!
How's this happening?
Dark and velvet! Enough waiting! Shield people! Swallow them! Shield people! That! Devour!
Shield people! No escape! You're wide open! Bird!
Strike! Out of my way!
Damn, that thing got rolled!
Crash through!
You're wide open!
Take that! Devour!
Dark and light!
Too slow! No escape!
No escape!
Spin it! You're
defending! I'll help you!
You're wide
Take
open!
Quick way!
Dead yet!
Devour!
Better watch your step!
Shield, I'll help you! Crash through!
Shield, you're wide open!
You're just lucky I made it quick.
That was tough.
Yeah. There are things worse than death.
Wait, what game's that from? Wait, why are these holes everywhere? Ah, screw it. In we go. This is new. That's our chest. Ooh, I actually think those are exactly what we don't need. No, we do need them. Just not now. Alright, we're done. That's all the chests, that's everything we need. Main story time. This area is annoying. Let's move on. If we go straight, I'm gonna guess there's maybe a... No, there isn't. What is that going to be? Are we going to be able to fly or something? I don't know. It'd be really cool if you could like double tap square, right? Or X or whatever. And while you're moving, it would show the full area map, right? So it would show this. If you like double tap square. And after a couple of seconds, it would go back. Or just maybe show the whole thing. I don't know. Maybe that'd be too much on the screen, though.
Praetor Eleanor, you should be ashamed of yourself, cowering to demons.
Your collusion could spell disaster to the Abbey if left unchecked. The only possible atonement is your death.
That's it.
No escape!
I'm gonna get it back! Devour!
I'm finished! Disclosure!
How's that? No escape!
Here it comes! Here it comes!
Life
begun! Check the
heavens!
Fate pierce! Tip-tap!
That guy got yeeted into the Nether Realm. Perfect dodge.
No, no.
Here. Huh?
No escape.
Here it comes.
Nice. She's really fun to use. She's probably my favorite after Velvet.
You've betrayed the people and sullied Artorias' ideals.
No, that's not... Velvet, she's testing me.
I knew it!
I know I have to fight. My mission calls for it. But any more of this will kill them.
Time for you to die and be purged!
Eleanor!
I can't do it. I can't kill them.
I'm not done yet.
There. Now we're even, Eleanor.
You've got new swords. Sinister. Nice. I like it.
I take it you're ready.
Yeah. All that's left is to kill Shigure.
I mean, they could have made the swords look
witness.
I keep on fighting like that, and you'll be killed. And if you get killed, Lafayette will lose his vessel.
I know that.
But it's a job.
Wait.
You're not going to kill them?
You are.
I'm just not that hungry right now. I've got new orders for you. Fight the exorcists, but make sure they don't die.
Understood.
What? Why? Huh.
I guess that was as far as Eleanor could go.
I think so. Push her any further and she's bound to break.
Ever the virtuous exorcist.
That very virtue is what lets her be Lafayette's vessel. Besides, I can't help but admire her commitment. She's enduring total disgrace to accomplish her mission.
How uncommonly pleasant of you.
Pleasant folks don't use people the way we do.
Yeah, you've got that right.
Your
Let's
mom's a frickin' walrus. I'm trying to do the hold R2 thing. There it is. Holy crap. Oh my
hey,
god.
Is everyone all right?
Oh, okay. I think I get it now.
Hey, Bienfu. I was wondering if I could talk to you about something that's on my mind.
I figured it was just about the time that you and I had the talk, actually.
Oh, God.
I've seen it all, heard it all, and even tasted it all in my time as a Moloch. Ask me anything you want.
Thanks. I was hoping you could let me borrow those books you were reading earlier.
Oh, no.
If that's okay.
You mean how to talk a human female into becoming your vessel? And how to get the cuties?
Hey! Keep it down! Keep it down!
But you and Madame Eleanor have already formed a pact! Why do you still need either of those books?
Well, it's like when we're alone together, things get so awkward. It's hard to talk with her, you know?
Oh.
That happens a lot with Malachiman vessels who are still new to the whole thing. I've been there. In that case, I've got an even better book for you.
Whoa, you read a lot of books.
I'm just an avid learner is all. Now let's see. Oh, here we go.
Please don't be creepy. Please don't be creepy.
Spring topics, bearing your body and your soul. Being upfront and honest is always the best policy.
I don't think we'll be bathing in any hot springs together. Do you have anything else?
All right, then how about after bath party games? Dropping your defenses and your towels.
Why do you keep trying to get us naked? I think that would just make things even more awkward.
Yeah. Picky. Tell you what, you can just look at my collection and pick whatever sounds good.
Love hacking. Living long and loving hard.
God's sake.
Diary of a diary thief. Hands speak louder than words.
Oh, man.
All classics. I remember reading them when Miss Moggy Lou and I were struggling to get along. Oh, to be young again.
I don't even want to know.
You ever think maybe things would have been easier if you never read these books?
Reading the mood. Knowing what to say and how to say it. That one's a winner. A must read for sure.
Are you two reading something together?
We are. Lafayette's been worried about that awkward distance between you two, and he came to me for some advice. I've heard his side of the story, so let's you and I grab some tea and talk about what to do about it. Come on! Let's go!
Oh, okay.
Knowing what to say and how to say it. I don't think this will help either.
JRPGs. There's always some weirdness in there. There's always some uncomfortable weirdness in there. Alright. I guess we're going tunnels port side. Which is behind us. Though I literally just went the wrong way. Go away, Zombie. Oh, it should be good. I think this is right. This place is confusing. Wait. Is this right? My head hurts. Meet Sugar at the port past the mine. I have no idea what I'm doing. Maybe this way. All right. Okay. And I would assume that those two connect and we can get to the secret boss. So, is it just one? Nope, it's not. Oh, is this one? Although, I saw you. Oh, these don't count as chests? Wow. Oh, nice.
Hey, Rokuro. Why did he call your storm howl a reject?
Must be going the right way.
Well, you see, when blacksmiths make swords, they don't just make one at a time. They make a whole bunch. The best one of them all is the one that gets presented to the sword's commissioner, while the rest are tossed aside.
Huh. I didn't realize the standards were so high.
The head of my clan gets the real storm howl, and his siblings get the remainders.
So one is real, and the others are imitations?
I guess so. Shigure has the real one, and... yeah, guess that makes mine an imitation.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to imply...
Don't apologize. You got me to finally realize something. It might just be why I'm so hung up on beating him.
Oh.
And to Velvet, which Lafayette is real, and which is the imitation?
Damn.
What are you saying?
She means my name. It's the same as Velvet's brother's.
Huh? The one who went and got sacrificed by Artorias. Surely you are mistaken. Our shepherd would never do such a thing.
But what else could make Velvet hate Artorias so much?
I don't... So you have a truth, and Velvet has a truth. Now which is the real one, and which is the imitation?
Oh god, I love dot dot dots. People need to do that in real life when they're thinking. Yeah. Just a little bit of an almost sexual moan never hurt nobody. You know, it's like dot dot dots is what tennis players do when they play tennis. That's it. It's a couple of dot dot dots never hurt nobody. Now, if you close your eyes and listen to it, you may think other things, but you know. What am I even talking about? Let's just move on. You know what to expect on this channel. The really important conversations. I have no idea how I'm going to get there. Unless... Ooh, I want that. I've got a lot of these to use. This must be the way to the boss. There must be a hole here. There isn't! How the hell do we get there then? In the arms of an angel. I still haven't farmed in this game once, which is cool. You know, normal mode, you shouldn't really be forced to be farming. If I was playing hard mode or expert, whatever it's called, I would expect to farm now and then. Oh, maybe it's that little room takes you there. But I do want to get my arts stronger, so maybe a little bit of farming. I thought this game was going to be open world. I was completely wrong. Not open world, but like open world linear sort of. But no, it's just a very fun linear JRPG. And bro, there are so many open world games out there. Like, it's nice to just, you know, explore, but also sort of know where I'm going and stuff. Like, I don't know. I'm really enjoying this game, man. I really am. And if this isn't the best that Tails has to offer... I mean, I haven't finished yet. You know, you never know. But if this isn't the best that Tails has to offer, I can't wait to see what is the best. You know what I mean? I'll have to, like, see what your guys' comments are. Regarding, you know, maybe your top five Tails of games or Tails games you recommend... It doesn't have to be, you know, officially on PC. I can get the old As long as I'm on PC and it's not, you know. PS3 ones, I don't know about. I don't know what emulators are like on PS3. But, the ones I know that are available on PC are Vesperia, Symphonia. I think that's it. Oh, and Zestiria? How did I remember those? My memory works in weird, weird ways, man. Weird, weird ways. Anyone else have that problem? Huh. I don't know how we're gonna get down there. Never mind.
You and Shigure both use the Rangetsu style. But to me it looked like you both fight completely differently. Why is that?
Our school encompasses two distinct forms. To the outside world, we're known for fighting with a single great sword. But we also study dual short swords should need arise.
So, Shigure uses the great sword, and you use the short.
In most schools, wouldn't the secondary technique be used primarily in support of the first?
That's true for us as well. We learn the dual short swords to provide sparring partners for those studying the great sword.
Then why would you handicap yourself against Lord Shigure? He's no mere swordsman.
As I'm painfully aware, Shigure is a true master. We trained together since we were small children. I was his sparring partner for 10 years. His skill with the great sword is godlike. So, in order to beat him, I took up the short blades. To our school, it might be secondary, but it's what I know best.
You're badly disadvantaged in reach.
If I eliminate my fear, I have a chance. If I can control the terror of being split in half, and I can step inside his guard, he'll have 2 times the trouble.
Eliminating fear, huh? A style for someone who's lost his humanity.
Right?
It's like you two brothers are the very swords you carry.
Huh?
Makes
sense. Storm Howl, a godlike sword known to all as the strongest there ever was. Storm Quell, burdened by the ceaseless struggle to best the other. One, an exorcist who walks in the light. One, a demon moving through the shadows. The only thing these two polar opposites want
is to cut down the other.
Precisely!
Both are renowned blades. But I don't see what exorcists and demons have to do with it.
It's like Maggie's like a narrator. But she's in the group, which is really a really cool idea. I like that. I can't wait to learn her real motive and why she's here. Alright, it's been a while, so. Okay, I didn't want that to happen, but.
Ready to die?
Oh, think you straight going in there.
Just try! Perfect mayhem!
Devour!
No escape! Who wants some next?
That'll do it.
I hope I did a good job.
That'll do it. You did good, kid.
Don't get careless.
You did good.
How's this? Let's go.
Crash! Take that! Devour! Take that!
Holy crap.
It's over, right?
I might have just missed some mastery. Nope. Okay.
I'll end this quickly.
No
what the? Oh, it slows us.
Crash through! Split! Take that! need to power!
I got rolled. I think she can't hurt this guy. Oh my god, that damage!
No escape! Hurricane crushing! Armor crusher! Come! How's that crushing? No deception! For one!
I'll help you!
See this? Armor crusher!
Let's go!
For three! Hurricane! I'll stop you! Deception!
No
escape!
Enough waiting!
Its guardian was angry at it.
Hold on. You can read a guardian's heart?
Yeah, sort of.
Damn. Alright. Okay, so you're done with Fluoric Boots. Yes. Nice.
I knew this would be big.
Ooh.
What a treasure!
Yggdrasil's goddess statue, a statue pulled up from the Exphere Sea, depicting a beautiful goddess. The figure is imbued with a mysterious energy that causes it to gradually move over time.
Scout ship setting sail.
She's so pretty.
An image of the goddess Martell. She takes many forms across several mythologies, but always is the guardian of the world tree.
Really?
Aye. According to legend, the tree stands at the center of the world and produces life energy. Martell watches over the tree alongside the spirit that dwells within it.
I see. I'd like to meet this goddess someday.
Well, well, Lafayette. I didn't know you were into all the girls.
Huh? Older girls?
There's no need to be ashamed. It's a phase most boys go through at one time or another.
Alright. Am I 10 years old or 13 years old? How old is this kid?
I'm just going to assume he's like 13, 14 and they're just, you know. Oh god, this game's weird. Everything's weird. Just run, just run! I think we know he's about 13, I think. No, wait, he can't be, right? He's at the age of 12. What's his name gonna die? Well, this is nice and cheerful. Port Cadnix. Oh. Hey. Tranquillo. Yes, please. Yes, please. Okay, the inn's locked. Now this is some beautiful, like, happy-go-lucky JRPG music. We've made it! Ooh. We've made it to the port, ladies and gentlemen. We will leave this for next time! Thank you so much for watching. I really, really appreciate it. Again, as I alluded to, I think it was this episode. Let me know the tales of games that you regard as the best. Not necessarily the reasons why. If you want to give me some reasons, like, you know, non-spoilery, then go for it. Or maybe that's, you know, you see me enjoying this one and they're similar to that. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. Thanks for being you. I appreciate you joining me on this journey. And next episode is going to be a great one. So see you then. Bye-bye.